Welcome back to The Witcher 3. I am going to head over to the Peller's Hut, over here to continue the main quest. And I think along the way I'm probably going to stop at Blackbow, because I think there's a fist-fighting person that I need to fight there, I think. Pretty sure. Yeah, I believe there was one at Blackbow and one at the Inn at the Crossroads. So let's head on over there.
Let's go!
Man, is it dreary right now, this weather. I love this new saddle. I can ride for so long. Oh, hey, wait a minute. These are the racing people. Okay, whoa, what? What's wrong? Oh shit, there's bandits. That's why he's freaking out. Although these dudes are just smoking and they don't give a damn. Dude, it's okay. It's okay, man. Don't worry. I got this. I just clicked out of the game somehow. How did that happen? Let me click back inside of the game. And stab this bandit. I don't know how that was possible. I just stabbed him even though I wasn't near him. Next. Oh, you don't get an execution. That's weird. Next. I love the way he elegantly fell on the fence. I don't need no Quen. You can't hit me. Try again. Oh, okay. You know, this isn't fun anymore. What just happened? It's like he got caught in some sort of Matrix slow-mo scene and then it just stopped. You know, I feel like he's like part of a scene and I'm not like privy to what's going on. I feel out of place here. I feel kind of uncomfortable. Am I supposed to be posing along with him? There we go. Go to sleep. Okay, as I was saying, if you're done freaking out, the little bandits have been killed. You know, I find it funny, this guy, if you remember when I talked to him before, he was such a badass, you know? Like, he seemed like such a tough dude, and then some bandits come around, and he starts screaming. I think you're all bark and no bite. Anyway, so if you remember, this is the horse race guy, and I thought the horse races were rigged, but somebody in the comments told me that they actually aren't. So I'm gonna try him again.
So what'll it be? Gonna run?
Wanna?
Don't. Good day, Grey One. So.
Let's do a rematch for Iron Arshans. Bet the max.
See how that spins.
Come on.
Alright, so this time, don't sprint the entire time. Right, that's basically the tip. Don't sprint the entire time. And don't bother with the GPS, just follow the flags, it's better. What the? Why am I in slow motion? What? What the? Oh. Barrels are coming at my face, apparently. I believe there's something to jump over. Oh, blocking you off. Blocking you off. Alright, now I'm gonna keep sprinting. Nice jump. Yeah, we got this.
Faster, Beecher, faster! Gonna wrap up before you when we're through.
We got this. Easy peasy.
Slow now.
Nice, nice.
Alright.
Alright, next.
So what'll it be?
Wanna
don't. Good day, Grey. So
right.
Oh crap, thank I just bet the default.
Come on.
Whoops. Whatever, I got this. I'm sorry, what? Please don't do that to your horse, you fucking asshole. He's just talking about abusing his horse just to get a little bit of extra speed. Alright, stop sprinting. Stop sprinting.
I'll be first if I have to skewer my mare with my spurs.
Yeah, just gotta conserve your stamina a little bit.
Hey, Witcher! You have no one yet!
Hey there!
Nice, nice!
Oh. They all left. Horse blinders. Already got them. But let's see if there may be better horse blinders or something. Also got saddlebags. How does that compare to my... Oh, no, the ones I bought are way better. Yeah, the ones I bought give me 70 maximum inventory weight increase. These only give me 30. Yeah, these horse blinders are the same. Oh well, got some coin out of it. Alright, back to what I was doing. Should be a village coming up here soon. Yeah, isn't it? Around here? Ah, close, I'm on the outskirts. Alright, so let's switch to that quest, the fisting quest. Yeah, there should be one right over here, right? Mm-hmm, right there. Excuse me, I've come from the night to fist some dudes. Where is Smithy?
Come on, Gens.
There we go.
Since the locals are... Will you join the tournament? Hey, eh? A bit of honest fist fighting to clear the lungs and bowels. Though I warn you, Jonah can be fierce. Likes to bite. Get me? So, what'll it be?
To do this, all in.
All right. Let's see just how fierce Jonah is.
Feast your eyes on an epic clash between Jonah and the Drifter.
Yeah, tire yourself out with your fancy footwork. I'm not moving. He's just moving into the building now. What are you doing, dude? Come on. was so easy. Oh my god.
Drifters defeated Jonah. Could this be a new champion of Velen in the making? Who can tell? You have still Smithy to fight. Don't put it off. Rubble everywhere.
Doggy.
Maybe I should send you down to the creek. Might catch something.
Doggy. Look at those moves. Rolled over a kiln. Yeah. Alright, where is Smithy? 800 paces away, huh?
Run, Roach.
Or meters, or whatever. Paces sounds cooler, doesn't it? It's not that far away. I kind of want to just go do it. Ah, but the hut's right here. Let's just go do the hut.
It's plowing, pouring again.
Oh. What's going on here?
What do you want?
Want to talk to the Peller.
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
Let's just get information first.
What do you want from him?
To give him what he deserves.
And that is?
He done conjured auguries. Said something evil had made its nest in Edric's bowels. Told Edric to eat rowan berries. Lots of them.
Ever since Edric's lived in the outhouse. And he's got hardened pustules all over him.
Ew. Let's try to make a deal.
Just so happens I need the Peller alive. So if you agree to leave him alone, for good, I'm willing to tell you how to help Edric.
Well, all in all...
Yes or no?
Fine. Let's hear it.
A tea of mullein leaves for his belly, and cover his boils with mallow. A few days and he'll be good as new.
Noted. But if it don't work, we'll be back. Move out, boys.
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up.
My old lady on that. Got a knack for herb shooters. The other shot, Mallow.
Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils, who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Ooh, a man. Nay, a wolf. Grey, though not old. Tis he the Peller awaits.
You were expecting me.
Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
So, designed to protect her. From what?
Oh, the dear. Besieged she was, evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
Tis not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more a Peller could do.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay, no, nay. Peller don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pella will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits? Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost. Lost. Must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess, my goat! She's fled!
I'm sorry, you're gonna ask your goat?
The men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat, impossible. No goat, won't work.
I've gotta find his goat. I'm not gonna refuse to chase down some goat. Let's find this poor goat.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell! The little bell's ringing! She loves it! Ring, ring, and she will follow. But for a while. But beware of wild strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah, treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them.
I've got to actually use it. Okay. Alright. Shove that bell in my quick slot icon. Wait, where is it? Oh, it's already been equipped. Cool. Alright, my Witcher senses plus bell equals goat.
This way, I think.
Princess! Princess!
Another clue. Good. Another clue.
Good, good, good. Another clue. Good, good, good.
Good. This way, I think. Good. This way, I think. Another clue. This way, I think.
Is that? I think it's over here. Oh wait, there's beasts here. Alright, I don't want to get mobbed, hold on. Poison? I don't really want poison. Never mind. Forget that. I'm just gonna tank the damage. Princess, you really like to loop around. Oh yeah, I just heard it. There you are, princess. Come here. I'm amazed princess hasn't been eaten by the wolves yet. Look at how many are out here. Princess! Meh! Meh!
There you are.
Aww. Come here.
Here, goat. Here, princess. Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn.
Aw, princess is adorable.
Alright, time to try the bell. Come on, let's go see the beller. Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? Come on, damn it.
Where are you going? Are you going backwards?
Where the hell do you go?
Where are you going? Come here. Princess.
Bear.
Oh god.
Bear! Run, you stupid piece of shit!
Oh god! Oh my god! Freaking princess! What have you done? Alright, let's put some beast oil on. Let's see, what do I want? Poison, should I try fire? I could try fire. Let's try Dragon's Dream. Problem is it needs to stay in the cloud. Let's just make it keep running through the cloud. Come on. It's not really that effective, honestly. Bears killed a bunch of people. I can't pick it? No, I can't. Weird. I don't know why it's highlighted. Alright, Princess, just follow me for a second.
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow?
I'm gonna go check out this cave. It's another goat. At least it's not Princess. You're not actually gonna come into the cave, are you? Oh god, you're actually coming into the cave. Okay. Don't know if that's a good idea. You know, that kind of makes it harder to see. Well, kinda. Ew, I just picked up rotting flesh. Why did I pick that up? Master crafted ursine steel sword. That sounds nice. In fact, why don't we check it out right now? Steel sword. Steel, 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 steel. Alright, that's what level is it? Just level 34! Yeah, I'll look at that recipe again in like 2 months. Princess. Princess. Maybe I shouldn't run. I'm not gonna run. Okay, I'm actually gonna run a little bit. This is the best escort quest ever. Look who's here!
Princess! Flee not from the pillar, for there are wolves about! Goat of mine! Dearest, sweetest goat!
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The White Wolf helped the Pella, and so the Pella shall help him. Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back.
What about the giant bear that I just killed?
Will this do?
Goat's milk, rat's blood. I don't want to see it. Please don't. Are you gonna just like crush it with your hand or something? What are you gonna do? Okay, good. At least use a knife, yeah. Oh.
They are not here. There is gold. Blood. I see blood.
Whose?
No one. No Tamara. Just a child.
A child that lives not, yet did not die.
I have no idea what that means.
Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you, you must have noticed something.
The Peller's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders, it seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help, lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Why do you want its blood?
Blood, blood, blood. It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Peller.
And what does the Peller do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year, but we'll find a way, all the same.
I hear you right. You mentioned Forefather's Eve. Pretty old custom. Thought it had died out.
Death lurks in every bog and puddle round here. Folk know they could die, their earthly matters unresolved. Then they require help, or they'll not know peace. Forefather's Eve must be performed. Light the tallow candles to lead them through the dark. Call them by name, appease their regrets. Only then may they depart in peace.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight. Near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
this botchling sounds really, really terrifying. It says, read the beast chair to learn more about botchlings. Yeah, I want to know more about botchlings. Are they cursed ones? Yeah. Oh my god. Is it actually a... Is it actually, like, a fetus? Like a little baby monster? If it is... That's going to be really, really freaking creepy to talk to and maybe to fight if I have to fight it. Saying a botchling's ugly is like saying shit's not particularly tasty. Can't say it's a lie, but it doesn't exactly convey the whole truth either. Lambert. Botchlings are perhaps the most repulsive creature a witcher will ever have the displeasure of meeting. Born of dead, unwanted babies, discarded without a proper burial. Their appearance is that of a partially decayed fetus. Their unformed flesh twisted with hate, fear, and malice. These hideous creatures feed on the blood of pregnant women, driven by a mad hunger that most often leads to their victim's death. Oh my god, so this is the miscarried baby, right? Partially decayed fetus. Holy shit. And it sounds like I have a chance to actually cure its curse, which means I'm gonna talk to this partially decayed fetus first. Maybe. Well, I guess you don't necessarily have to talk to it to lift its curse, but still. I mean, I don't know what's more horrifying, the idea of talking with a partially decayed fetus, or the idea of killing a partially decayed fetus monster. I don't really know. Anyway, let's go talk to the Baron. See if he remembers a bit more than he told me before. He was obviously holding back.
Lightning strike.
Hmm? Oh, what the hell? It's on fire. What is going on? Okay, something big is going down.
Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
Believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid. Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
Yeah, of course I'm gonna help. Jesus Christ, let's go.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick!
Alright, gotta be fast. No time to think.
Well, it's getting worse and worse. Baron, sir, time to leave's approaching.
Calm yourself before you burn the castle down.
Sounds like the Baron is flying into a rage, but I can't deal with that right now. Alright, yeah, let's go up here. Come on.
Damn it, lots of smoke. Gotta hurry.
Let him out.
Open the door!
Gotta open a door somewhere. What door?
Put him in the mouth.
with a hero in our midst. You've earned yourself a barrel of Lyrian.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
What the fuck are you suggesting?
Don't play me for a fool. You'd been beating them for years. Finally, they'd had enough and fled. Sound about right?
Oh, here we go.
They ran from you, didn't they?
Lying prick!
We need to talk. Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story. She always knew how to spark my ire.
You know, my first impression, if you remember, of the Baron a long time ago, was that he got the name Bloody Baron because he's a piece of shit. And my first impression of him was, yeah, seems like he is. And then I thought, maybe not. You know, maybe he had earned the name the Bloody Baron, or rather, maybe he hadn't earned the name Bloody Baron. Maybe it had just been given to him. Maybe I have the wrong impression. Maybe he's not so bad. But no. He is. He is a piece of shit.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Maybe you shouldn't try to control them at all. Maybe you shouldn't associate controlling your family with masculinity.
Tell me everything you remember about the day they fled. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
I have basically no sympathy for him.
Tamara present for all this? She see you quarrel?
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Aye. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and a pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table, spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
I fell down on the landing. That must have been why the protective medallion that Anna got from the Peller, that must have been why it was found around the stairs, right around the landing. It must have fallen off her when they fell.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, and Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Maybe you're doing, maybe not. But that amulet she wore could be important, or maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
What was I to do? Took it out and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
Yeah, and you fucking killed her.
Get hold of yourself. Men like you, when they break down, look downright pathetic.
You're a heartless bastard.
Mutations worked then. But here's the good news. Your dead child might help us find the one who's still alive. And your wife.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
You don't need the details. No. You know what? I'll give you the details. You want to know what happened? You want to know you did?
A cursed creature that draws strength from killing pregnant women. Once it's strong enough, it attacks those who scorned it.
But how? How does it know?
Blood ties. They're a strong bond. A bond I want to use to find your family.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way. The sooner we resolve this, the better. Best do it tonight, at midnight.
Then wait here with me. Near midnight, I'll take you to where I buried her.
Get word to the common folk. Ought to stay in their homes tonight and draw a line of salt outside their doors. And try to sober up.
Do I take a shovel to dig up the grave?
Take it. You'll need it, but not for that.
I'm not looking forward to this.
A bit further. Follow me.
Give the child a name?
No. Why would we?
Mistake. Names are powerful seals.
I really don't want to see this thing.
Here's the spot.
chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm plowing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
Oh, God.
Look!
Jesus fucking Christ.
Take it in your arms, quick.
And if it goes Garrity, it'll bite us in the arse before we know it.
Keep screaming and it will turn rabid. It's calm for now.
Bloody hell. What happens when it gets plowing restless?
It'll bite through your jugular, and you'll bleed to death before I can help. Tell me if it starts wriggling. I'll calm it with magic. Pick it up. Take it in your arms.
The sounds that it makes. The sounds.
Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
Let's get this over with right now.
You were the one who wanted to test the old legends, change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck.
Said if it starts wriggling, I'll calm it with magic, so I'm gonna stay behind him ready to do that if I can. Jesus Christ. Some oil.
Do
coming down. Use the axe sign.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh. Quiet now. But what do you want to do with it?
Me? Nothing. This is your job. Told you, gotta bury it under the threshold. The tales are true, by tomorrow it'll be a lubricant. From then on, it'll watch over your house and help me find your family.
I'm just gonna tank the damage, basically. Alright, maybe not a good idea. Not a good idea. Oh god, oh
shit!
Oh god, no! When was the last save from? Oh! I started trying to tank the damage, which was a bad idea. I stopped, but I still failed. I hope my save game isn't from, like, the beginning of that whole sequence, because I don't want to see that thing again! Hoping there's a checkpoint. Please be a checkpoint. Is this right back? Oh no, this is back to the beginning! Oh, I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. Let's try this again.
What now?
More coming. Need to hurry.
On with it!
Getting mobbed. I'm just gonna take a swallow, just to get my health back.
Chosen a name?
No.
So think of one. It's important.
It's a girl. What would Anna have named her?
I feel like I might have to fight one more wave.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter.
Good. Now bury the body.
What now?
In one day's time, Daya should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. And the guilt, the responsibility for all this, lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home. And try not to drink yourself stupid again.
Okay. Just need to wait now, right? Will that be enough time? Let's wait longer just to be certain. A full day and a full night. Oh. I'm just supposed to press E.
By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Dea. Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
I was hoping the Lubberkin might look a little more, you know, pleasant. It glows nicely, but it still has the same horrifying shape that it had as a botchling. I guess it's supposed to be like a guardian angel, but I don't know, if I saw that face, I wouldn't feel protected. I would have nightmares.
Time to water the horses.
Sure wasn't lavender they kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. Horseshoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it.
So they were here.
Clothing. They change in here. Both were here. I'm going the right way. Wants to show me something more.
Ugh. I thought those were drowners at first, but they're not. Wait, it's here?
Necrophages had a field day. Still worth a closer look.
Oh god, is it gonna blow? Was it? Ooh! Okay, they explode. Gotcha. Oh.
Oh.
been cut off. Or, well, maybe it fell to the ground, and then maybe they chewed off its neck afterwards, the rot fiends or whatever these were.
What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Head torn clear off. Takes incredible strength.
Yeah, the head wasn't torn off. I mean, the head wasn't cut off cleanly with a sword or something like that. It's been, like, ripped off, shredded off, bitten off.
Must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here.
Well, I was planning on letting this episode be as long as it needs to be to complete this Family Matters quest, or at least this part of it, but I think I have to end it here. Like, I think this episode might be over an hour long at this point. And I feel like it's not going to end super soon. So I think I better end it here, as awkward of a time as it is. Yeah, this quest has been without a doubt the most disturbing in The Witcher 3 so far. Just, I don't even want to think about it. Yeah, I don't even want to think about it. I'm just gonna go. So, hope you've enjoyed so far. I'll be back soon.